Hi, let's talk about the respiratory system. Today I'd like to give you a quick overview of the anatomy and the functions of the respiratory system. So the anatomy of the respiratory system is relatively straightforward. There are two pathways by which gases may enter and leave the body. The first would be through the nostrils and the nasal cavity. The second would be through the mouth and the oral cavity. Both of these pathways come together in a common area called the pharynx, or colloquially, your throat. The pharynx is continuous with your voice box, or larynx, which is then continuous with your trachea, which is the base of your bronchial tree. The bronchial tree are your bronchi, primary, secondary, and tertiary, all of the bronchioles and the alveoli that they support. Finally, we have the lungs. The lungs host and surround the bronchial tree. The lungs are the heavy lifters of the respiratory system, so to speak. This is where gas exchange occurs. Now, the respiratory system is quite streamlined with respect to function. There are three major things that the respiratory system accomplishes for the body. The first being gas exchange. Your body needs oxygen to live, and it needs to rid itself of carbon dioxide. Now, these are opposite sides of the same coin. The oxygen is the terminal proton acceptor in chemiosmosis, which is the last stage of glucose catabolism, where an individual is able to produce copious amounts of ATP to power all of their endergonic cellular reactions. Whereas carbon dioxide is a byproduct of glucose catabolism and needs to be removed from metabolically active tissues. You may recall from the cardiovascular system that the respiratory system is helpful with respect to maintaining pH homeostasis. Carbon dioxide as a volatile gas can lower the pH of the blood. And if an individual were to increase their rate of respiration, if they were to breathe faster, they can blow off more carbon dioxide and thus help to increase the pH of the blood or make it less acidic. Another important function of the respiratory system is the production of sound and vocalization. This is accomplished using portions of the larynx or your voice box. In particular, there are vocal folds containing vocal ligaments. As these vocal folds are abducted or brought together and air is passed over them rapidly, they vibrate. As they vibrate, they produce sound. And that sound may be shaped by our oral cavity and its constituents. It may be provided resonance by our nasal cavity, and this is one of the major ways in which we can communicate. A third function of the respiratory system is to nexus with the nervous system for olfaction. As air is brought in through the nose and enters the nasal cavity, it's provided with some turbulence. That turbulence brings odorants within the air into contact with the olfactory nerves, cranial nerve 1. These come down through the ethmoid bone, through the olfactory foramina, and this is the basis of smell or olfaction. So we've discussed some of the major portions of the respiratory system and its functions. Let's talk about these things in a little more detail.